We're going to review the tests for meter turn-on procedure. Lockup, seepage, manometer, and dial. The first one we're going to do is lockup. Lockup tests the regulator, that the regulator is seated and closed when there's no flow downstream. And we will also talk about venting. The regulator vents at 14 inches water column. Our pressure on our system is 7.5 inches water column, and we will set up the manometer to do the test. So we're installing the tubing on the test port on the outlet of the meter. For this test, the valve needs to be in the on position. So we'll turn it on, and you can see we've got our static pressure of 7.5 inches water column. We're going to let this sit for 2 to 3 minutes to see if it continues to creep up. If it creeps up, that's when we know that our regulator isn't properly shut off, and it would go up to at least 14 inches water column. If for some reason the city pressure came over our 14 inches water column, it's going to relieve it to the outdoors through the vent. So with the valve on, it's set at 7.5 inches water column, and it has passed its test because it hasn't moved. Seepage test. Seepage test tests the wing valve. The wing valve has grease in it, and if the grease dries out inside the wing valve, it tends to dry out and crack, and that way it has little pathways for the gas to pass through it. So for this test, we need to have the gas valve shut off, and we need to bring down our water column pressure to 5.5 inches. We do that by just taking it on and off until I reach my 5.5. So again, we're going to wait for 3 minutes, and if it stays put, we know our grease is in good shape. If the pressure creeps back up, we know that our grease is dried out and cracked and letting gas pass through it. And because the wing valve is upstream of the meter, it's the responsibility of the gas company to grease the fitting. So you just make a report and let them do it. As a service technician, you won't be actually affecting repair on that. Next test is manometer, so we need to get back to static pressure again. And for the manometer test, we're checking for leaks from the meter down to the inlet of the gas valve. We shut this valve off. We make sure that our drop valve beside the appliance is in the on position, and we have our 7.5 inches water column. While we're doing this, we will take the opportunity, because we're doing this for 10 minutes, to soak all of our fittings right from the meter all the way to the inlet of the gas valve. So we're leak checking two ways, with both soap and with the manometer. So the last test is a dial test. There are two things you can check quickly with the dial. You have consumption dials across the top before them. There's two test dials. In the Imperial one, it's 2 cubic feet and 0.5 cubic foot. I'm going to put a piece of tape on my 0.5 cubic foot dial so that if it moves, I'll be able to see it move. And the first thing you can check is just to make sure that your meter is actually registering gas passing through. We need the valve on for this to start. It's definitely moved. It's just checking to make sure that your meter is reading. I'm going to reposition my tape. It seems to be turning that way, so we'll put my tape on the side so you can see it move away from the tape. And so, dial test is another way to leak check the line. So I put my tape on the smallest dial. I close my valve, so if there's any leaks downstream, it's going to show up because the dial is going to move. And of course, while I'm doing that, 10 minutes, I'm going to take my soap and go look for the leak. Obviously, I'm thinking I have a leak somewhere, so I'm going to A, see if I have a leak, and B, while I'm doing that, I'm soaping so that I can find the actual location of the leak. We're going to soap our test ports now that we're done to make sure that we didn't leave any leaks. The work that we did better.